So again, over charcoal.
Divine.
This over
which
over
is
a
how
barbecue.
They do it on the streets in in Vietnam, anywhere in Vietnam, you know.
There we go. This lemongrass barbecued pork that I'm doing is kind of Vietnamese for obvious reasons. The kind of thing that you would get on a broken rice. And broken rice is just one of my absolute favourite things to eat. But I think for home cooking, it can be a little bit difficult. There's a lot of elements, you know, that go in there. So I do a very simplified version. This is my very simplified broken rice. Starting with pork belly. One of the big myths, I think, you still find a lot of people that say pork belly has to be cooked for a long time because it's tough, and it's absolutely not.
Because it's got all the fat running through it, so it keeps the meat moist.
You know, you can stir fry it, you can do whatever with it. So I'm just cutting it into some very thin, not very thin, but sort of 1 centimetre thick slices. I'm going to marinate
this. So they'll cook fairly quickly anyway.
We're just going to cook those on the barbecue. Marinate that with, there's some garlic and onion in there. Going to throw in, actually, I'll chop my lemongrass first, is what I will do.
Key ingredient.
Key ingredient, otherwise I'll get in trouble. How much of the lemongrass do you use?
I use about what you've done, like up to the big, almost the end of the white.
Yeah.
And then the top bit, like that, that's what I use for tea and
and you still have so
infusions.
Much flavour in those.
Yeah.
I'm just going to finely slice this and keep all of those. I do find I use lemongrass often. I end up with so much of those left over.
Yeah, but you can use this in I braise with this.
Yeah, put that into your rice when you're cooking your rice, just the ends. Try and not, same way as you would pan leaf. Yeah. And it get a nice little...
If I'm making satays and stuff, I'll bind all of this up into a brush and then I use that to brush onto the barbecue. What was your first job in a restaurant, Christine?
When I walked away from my teaching career, my partner's sister had opened a guest house in Robe, South Australia,
where
the crayfish port.
Yep.
And we both love cooking. We're both, you know, very, you know, good, you know, home cooks. So that's how it started.
So this is my marinade, some sugar, dark soy sauce, fish sauce, soy sauce, all going together. Whack that in the fridge overnight, and this is what you end up with.
So again, over charcoal.
Divine.
This over
which
over
is how
a barbecue.
They do it on the streets in Vietnam, anywhere in Vietnam, you know.
I know our key ingredient is lemongrass today, but if I don't have lemongrass, I just do the same marinade without lemongrass. Yeah.
Would you use lemon?
Yeah, you could use lemon juice or lime juice. Something like that. There we go. So your elements of your broken rice. I should probably explain for those at home who don't know what broken rice is. In Vietnam, broken rice were all the literally broken grains of rice that were cheap and affordable, kind of like they literally fell off the back of a truck kind of grains of rice that people would then use. But it's got this wonderful kind of sticky, softer texture than you get from jasmine rice. I don't have access to broken rice all the time. Ironically, you know, the thing that people never wanted to have is now the thing that...
It's key for making a good congee.
So what I'm going to do, put this to one side, and I'll fry an egg with that too, because the things you usually get with broken rice, you know, you sometimes get omelette, sometimes get various other things. I think with an egg, just a fried egg, makes so many dishes even better, a bit more.
Is this like a snack?
It's a meal. It's a whole meal. Like, we're going to put this... It's like almost like a Japanese-style rice bowl.
Okay.
Or Vietnamese-style rice bowl, what am I saying? Marty, how did you get started in restaurants?
I went to Germany to see my dad when I was about... at the end of grade 10, and I wasn't allowed to go back to the high school that I attended because they asked me not to...
What'd you do?
They asked me not to return.
What'd you do? Come on.
I was just naughty. I was just...
He still is.
And anyway, while I was away, my mum worked in a hotel in Brisbane City called Lennon's Hotel.
Oh,
and
God.
She secured me a place as a kitchen hand, which then went on to an apprenticeship. So I started in a hotel, in the kitchen, at 15, and it was really hard.
And back in the day, Lennon's Hotel was the posh posh place in town, wasn't it?
It was.
Really?
It had a roof, well, the main restaurant, the Hibiscus Room, if you remember correctly,
yes.
was on the 30th floor, which so you could see a lot of Brisbane Vegas.
I'm going to make a really quick, I actually forgot to do this just then, nok chum.
Oh, yeah. Uh-huh.
To go with this. And I think people struggle with, if they're not familiar with Asian cuisines, they struggle with how to balance the taste of something like this because it's sweet and sour and savoury all at the same time. And what I tend to say to people is disregard the chilli and the garlic that I've just put in there, but mix together the sweet and sour ingredients first because I think that allows people to have a little bit more control about how things are happening. So lemon juice, sugar and some vinegar in there.
Yep.
And then once you're dissolving that together, you can kind of taste the balance. Like
the sweet, sour and salty. Mm,
sweet and sour together at the moment, so it tastes good to me.
Yeah.
And I'm just looking for it to taste good, essentially. And then once you add the fish sauce in, you start to get this salty element to it. That is, I think, a much easy way of looking at it, because otherwise if you mix everything together first you kind of got
yes.
is it too salty, what do I add, do I add more
no, you're right.
sweetness or do
because
I add more
once
sourness
you add too much salt
it's
then...
very it can't take it away
no
so here the salt's going in
yeah
nice and I'll just add a bit of water to dilute that down
yep
so now before I overcook my egg I'm going to put my rice on a plate. Bit of the lemongrass pork. I'll slide my fried egg on there too. Top that with a bit of
stuff.
Tomato, cucumber, some herbs. Serve it with a nok chum and that's, I don't know, lemongrass pork belly on the barbecue.
Complete.
Great.